Hi there, this is Ajit here. TCPI is another forecasting method used in earned value management. What is it? How it is different than the other forecasting method which I explained in my previous session? How to calculate and interpret it is something that I'm going to discuss in this session. I'll be using the same example which I used in my previous session. Here's a quick recap of that. There's a project which want to build a 20 kilometer stretch of the road in 6 weeks time with a budget of $12,000. At the end of 3 weeks, project realizes that it has only completed 8 kilometer of the road stretch with the actual money or actual cost of $8,000. 12 kilometer stretch is still remaining with 3 weeks time. Now the earned value analysis is done and project realizes that 8 kilometer stretch translates into the value of just $4,800 delivered against the planned value of $6,000, wherein the actual cost spent is $8,000. CPI and SPI is calculated and that comes out to be 0.6 and 0.8 respectively. That shows that project is lagging behind both in cost performance and the scheduled performance front. At the end of 3 weeks, project can use some forecasting method based on some assumptions and scenarios to figure out what is the likely estimated at completion budget. So that way it is trying to understand an inside out view. Inside, they know the trade-offs and they want to understand the outside projection of the EAC. Other way around, they may also decide that they want to catch up with the BAC alone, irrespective of whatever the CPI stand at the end of 3 weeks. But for the remaining duration, they want to understand the desired cost performance level so that they can meet the target. Or they may revise the BAC to arrive on some EAC, fix it up for the remaining duration and understand what is the desired cost performance level so that they can catch up with this amount which they have fixed. This cost performance level is forecasted using the TCPI, that is to Complete Performnce Index. And how it is different than the other forecasting method, as I explained, the other forecasting method gives you the inside out view, wherein the TCPI gives you the outside in view. Outside meaning we have fixed up the BAC or EAC for the remaining duration, but we want to understand what is the desired cost performance index which could help to achieve it. There's another term which is which needs to be understood here is the CPIC, that is cumulative CPI. In this example, we calculated the CPI at the end of 3 weeks, but we could have calculated the CPI end of first week, end of second week, and then end of 3 weeks. In that case, whatever the CPI we would have calculated end of 3 weeks, that would have been the cumulative CPI. The formula for TCPI is cost of remaining work divided by remaining budget. Now, if we consider the situation where project want to go with the BAC alone, in that case, the TCPI formula will be BAC minus EV, BAC minus AC. We can understand it with reference to our example that we've taken. BAC minus EV meaning the project had only completed 8 kilometers of the road, which value only $4,800, wherein the approved budget is $12,000. The difference between this is the cost of the remaining work. BAC minus AC, that is remaining budget. The actual spent is $8,000. Wherein we want to achieve the target of $12,000. So difference between that would be the remaining budget in this scenario. The TCPI for that will be coming 1.8. Now if we consider another situation where this BAC has been revised to some EAC of $15,000, then the difference between this formula and that formula will be just this EAC, because we are now considering a revised budget here. The TCPI for this comes out to be 1.02. Now what if we revise this EAC further and increases it by 2000 to make it 17,000? In this case, the TCPI comes to be 0.8. So this is the calculation part of the TCPI. I have purposely taken three different examples to explain the concept. Let's see how do we interpret these. This is a simple graph where x-axis represents the time of 6 weeks, the y-axis represents the cumulative CPI. The blue line here shows the cost performance baseline at 1.0. The dotted line here shows the current status of the project at the end of 3 weeks, which is CPI is at 0.6. Now if we consider the first scenario where project want to achieve the BAC, the required TCPI for that is 1.8, that is here. That means project has to lift its performance from 0.6 to 1.8 for the remaining duration. That is the difference of 1.2. It is quite unlikely that project can do that. For the second scenario, the BAC is now revised to a EAC of 15,000. For that, the TCPI required is 1.02, which comes out to be somewhere here. Which is again a difference of 0.4 and more, highly unlikely to achieve. In the third scenario, the EAC is $17,000, and to achieve that, the TCPI required is 0.8. 0.8 comes out to be somewhere here, which is just a difference of 0.2. This is a likely scenario, as long as project can cut the cost on other unnecessary items, can cross-skill the team, can replace the junior members with the experienced folks, can ask team to stretch a little bit, or maybe the senior members also contribute to the designing and the coding part of it, and taking all those measures there. Now you can see how easily this forecasting method can help management to figure out whether the BAC could be met or different EAC which they are considering could be achieved or not. From PMP exam perspective, this subject may be sounding little tricky, but this is an interesting one. As long as you practice on it, you will be settled down very soon. Thanks for watching this video. Let me know your comments and feedback. Stay tuned.